My favorite Irish poet, William Butler Yeats, said, "We shall not cease from exploration, and the end of all of our exploring will be to arrive where we started and know the place for the first time." And here we are, in this room, with these people. The difference is 4 weeks of time. And as we think back on this time, it can seem as if indeed we are knowing this place for the first time. All I really want to say is thank you. Thanks all of you who, against all odds and against all the pressures to do otherwise, have chosen to be in the arts. In this era, of so many distractions, where many can't absorb a single complex thought without a soundbite, you have chosen a different path. A life in the arts means loving complexity and ambiguity, of enjoying the fact that there are no single absolute solutions. And it means that you value communicating about matters of the spirit, because you know that life is just not a transaction, not simply about winning someone's confidence purely for the purposes of material gain. John Adams, the composer, said, "Never consider yourself sufficiently educated. Be bold, be humble, and don't ever feel that what you're doing as an artist is marginal or unimportant in this country of ours. You are, in fact, the heart and soul of its very being, because you have the capacity to ask the real questions that good art provokes within us. Questions of morality, humanity, the range of identity, the importance of beauty, and ideas and qualities you can't quantify." The painter Robert Henri wrote, "When the motive of artists are true, when they are at their work as the result of deep consideration, when they believe in the importance of what they're doing, their work creates a stir in the world." That is my wish for you, that you create a stir in the world. I also want to thank you for the many generous acts I have witnessed this summer. How people gave to each other, how you supported each other, found compassion for each other, tried very hard to understand each other. I encourage you to be generous. There can never be enough of it. Regardless of where you are in your career, seek to mentor someone else. Recognize you have a responsibility to foster the passions, dreams, and aspirations of others. And there is almost always someone who has less experience than you. And once the gift has stirred within us, it is up to us to develop it. No agent, no director, or advocate of any kind will make your career for you. I believe the more control you have over your own career, the more generous you feel. Generosity requires an ethical approach. Honesty and openness are forms of generosity. Take the long view. It will give you endurance and protect you from the poison cloud of bitterness that hovers close in proximity to the life of the artist. Bitterness is the enemy of generosity. And get over the myth of entitlement. No one owes you anything in this business or in this life. The surest way to feel victimized is to feel owed, and to feel owed is to be in a deficit, and deficits leave you nothing to give. And I want to thank you for your effort, your risk, your searching, your joy, and your hope. And thanks to all of you who have stood behind you, stood alongside of you, those who have comforted and challenged you, because none of us can do this alone. I wish each of you an extraordinary and exceptional life.
I am honored. This is my first year as director of CSSSA, and I am honored to have been able to work with you, to get to know you, and to stand in front of you and close this time together. The CSSSA 21st anniversary season is now ended. Thank you.
You can come up here and get it directed. Just be easy. Don't rush him. Don't mob rush him.
himself to drugs. He took the midnight.